Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. I am Dr. Naureen Khan, lecturer of Biochemistry Department. Today I will start new chapter. The chapter name is Clinical Biochemistry. From this chapter, we will start the topic. The topic name is Diabetes mellitus. What is diabetes mellitus? When blood sugar will be high in your body, then that is known as the diabetes mellitus. So in the definition, we will tell it is a clinical syndrome which is characterized by persistent hyperglycemia due to absolute deficiency or relative deficiency of insulin or insulin resistance. It is known as the diabetes mellitus. Diabetes mellitus can be classified into several categories: type 1 diabetes mellitus, type 2 diabetes mellitus, secondary diabetes mellitus, gestational diabetes mellitus. Type 1 diabetes mellitus is known as the insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. There is some cause for type 1 diabetes mellitus. Idiopathic cause, when the cause is not known, and destruction of the pancreatic beta cell by the immunological assault. These two are the causes of type 1 diabetes mellitus. Type 2 diabetes mellitus is also known as the non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. In this diabetes mellitus, there will be at least 30% pancreatic beta cell active, but rest of the pancreatic beta cell are destroyed. For this reason, this diabetes mellitus occur. Beside this, there is another cause. Another cause is insulin resistance for type 2 diabetes mellitus. Type 2 diabetes mellitus is more common among the obese patients, and type 1 diabetes mellitus is common in case of the lean and thin patients. Normally, type 1 diabetes mellitus we will get before 35 years of age, and type 2 diabetes mellitus we will get above 35 years of age. In case of type 2 diabetes mellitus, genetic predisposition is very strong. Now come to the point number 3, that is secondary diabetes mellitus. The cause of secondary diabetes mellitus, there are some endocrine causes such as prolonged steroid therapy, prolonged Cushing syndrome, acromegaly, gigantism, hyperthyroidism. These are the causes of endocrine disorder for which diabetes mellitus can occur. Besides this, some pancreatic disorders such as pancreatitis, chronic liver disease, liver cirrhosis, and drug abuse such as steroid, oral contraceptive pills. For these reasons, secondary diabetes mellitus occur. Now come to the point 4, gestational diabetes mellitus. Gestational diabetes mellitus is the diabetes mellitus which is characterized by persistent hyperglycemia among the patient of pregnant lady who never had diabetes mellitus before the pregnancy, first time appeared during the pregnancy. That is gestational diabetes mellitus. So there are 4 categories of diabetes mellitus. Now we will discuss about the insulin resistance. We told about that the in case of type 2 diabetes mellitus, the main cause of type 2 diabetes mellitus is insulin resistance. What is insulin resistance? It is the reduced sensitivity of the target tissue or cells to respond to the insulin to causes the metabolic activity of the cell to insulin. So where there is a reduced sensitivity of the cell to respond to insulin, that is the insulin resistance. There are some causes of insulin resistance such as obesity, production of autoantibody against the insulin receptor, mutation of the insulin receptor, there is a hemochromatosis, iron overload, there is a gestational diabetes mellitus, prolonged steroid therapy or Cushing syndrome. These are the causes of insulin resistance. In case of insulin resistance, obviously we will do a test that is known as the random blood glucose test or fasting blood glucose test. So now we will discuss about the test which is known as the oral glucose tolerance test for diagnosis of the diabetes mellitus. Oral glucose tolerance test, OGTT test. At first, we have to know the aims or objectives of the OGTT test. The main aims or objective of the oral glucose tolerance test is to assess the endogenous insulin response to the physiological glucose challenge. So when we will give glucose from outside into our body, then our endogenous insulin, how it will respond to the excess amount of glucose which is taken from outside of the body, that is we will interpret through the OGTT, oral glucose tolerance test. For this reason, for doing oral glucose tolerance test, there are some preparations are unrestricted carbohydrate diet for at least 3 days and minimum 150 gram per day carbohydrate we have to intake for at least 3 days. Number two preparation is, if there is any infection, we have to treat the infection, avoid smoking and exercise prior to the test, overnight fasting for 8 to 10 hours or 10 to 12 hours prior to the test day. And number five is, when we will do the test, before that we have to stop some medications which can increase the blood glucose level. The medications are steroid or oral contraceptive pills which can enhance the blood glucose concentration. Now, what are the indication for oral glucose tolerance test? Indication is, when fasting blood glucose level less than 7 millimole per day or random blood glucose level within 7.8 to 11.0 millimole per liter, then that is the great indication for doing the oral glucose tolerance test. Another indication is, if there is a suspected case of pre-diabetes or gestational diabetes mellitus, in that case we have to perform oral glucose tolerance test. Besides this, if there is obesity, dyslipidemia and other risk factor, then we have to perform the oral glucose tolerance test. What is the procedure? Procedure is, after preparing oneself, then we have to go to the hospital to do the oral glucose tolerance test. At first, collection of the blood sample at early morning, especially in the fasting condition. And with the collection of the blood sample, we will give the urine sample too. Then after giving the fasting blood sample, we will take 75 gram glucose in 300 ml water, and for 5 minutes we will drink this, because to avoid any type of vomiting tendency or vomiting. After taking the oral glucose, after 2 hours of that oral glucose intake, we have to give another blood sample and corresponding urine sample. This is the procedure for performing oral glucose tolerance test. Now come to the interpretation. When we will tell it is normal or diabetes mellitus or impaired glucose tolerance or impaired fasting glucose condition. WHO, what is World Health Organization, this organization has given some criteria by which we can tell that this patient is diabetic or non-diabetic or pre-diabetic level. For this condition, when fasting blood glucose level will be less than 6.1 millimole per liter, and 2 hours after oral glucose tolerance test, when blood glucose will be less than 7.8 millimole per liter, we will tell it or interpret it as a normal. When the fasting blood glucose level is more than or equal to 7 millimole per liter, and 2 hours after oral glucose tolerance test, it will be more than or equal to 11.1 millimole per liter, then we will interpret it as a diabetes. And when fasting blood glucose is less than 7 and 2 hours after OGTT is within the 7.8 to 11.0, then we will interpret as the pre-diabetic. Another name is impaired glucose tolerance, because here impairment occurs in case of 2 hours after OGTT level. And if the blood glucose level is within the 6.1 to 6.9 millimole per liter, and 2 hours after oral glucose tolerance test it is less than 7.8 millimole per liter, then we will interpret it as a impaired fasting glucose. Also, it is a pre-diabetes condition, but here the patient mainly suffering from impaired fasting condition. Patient has blood glucose level impaired only in the fasting condition, not in the 2 hours after oral glucose condition. So after interpretation of the WHO criteria, normal diabetes mellitus, impaired glucose tolerance or impaired fasting glucose, now we will know about the what is the value of urine level of glucose. We also perform the glucose in the urine, but it has no diagnostic value because without the diabetes mellitus, in other condition also glucose can be present in the urine. And normally glucose can come into the urine when the renal threshold of glucose will be more, then glucose can come into the urine, such as renal glycosuria and elementary glycosuria. So glycosuria always not associated with diabetes mellitus. So most valuable is blood test, and that blood test level we have mentioned already. So this is all about today. So my topic diabetes mellitus up to oral glucose tolerance test is completed. Thank you all for your patience and hearing. Allah Hafiz.